Here's a sneak peek at an all-new Lion King motion picture event.
What's on the menu? It could be ceviche, I can see you, it's Pumbaa.
I gotta tell you, Timon, that song always gets me right here.
Yeah, Pumbaa. Well, enough of that.
Timon, what are you doing?
I'm fast-forwarding to the part where we come in.
But you can't go out of order.
Au contraire, my porcine pal. I've got the remote.
But everyone's gonna get confused. We gotta go back to the beginning of the story.
We're not in the beginning of the story.
Yes, we were the whole time.
Yeah, but they don't know that.
Then why don't we tell them our story?
Hey, I've got an idea. Why don't we tell them our story?
Oh, I like the sound of that.
A little backstage tour. Take them behind the scenes for a revealing and intimate look at the story within the story.
Because what they don't know is how we really were there, even though they didn't know we were there, you know?
Couldn't have said it better myself.
So, does this mean we're going back to the beginning?
Oh, no, Pumbaa. No. We're going way back to before the beginning. Wait. Hold on a second. Three? What's with the three? No. The three has got to go.
Timon, you can't use two. There's already been a two.
Ooh, you got a point there, big fella. It's not a sequel anyway.
Yeah, more like a behind-the-sequel.
A what, a hoquel?
Oh, you know, an in-betweenquel.
That's it. Pumbaa, my muse. It's genius. There! Now this title's a knockout! No! Not literally.
Since the dawn of civilization, the galaxies have echoed with the tales of ancient heroes. Now comes the story of one such hero, a beacon of hope, freedom, and justice throughout the universe. And for the first time ever, his galactic exploits are premiering only on video.
To infinity!
And beyond!
Disney presents Buzz Lightyear of Star Command, the movie. The story of Buzz's epic struggle with the evil Emperor Zurg. Coming soon to video and Disney DVD.
Premiering only on Disney DVD and video. The all-new Roly Poly Oly, the great defender of fun. Come along on Oly's newest, zaniest, out-of-this-world adventure.
It's Oly's birthday!
In this all-new, full-length movie, the party's just getting started until the fun is undone by... the newest villain from outer space.
Gloomius Maximus, the number one enemy of fun.
I hate birthday parties! No fun for anyone!
Played by veteran actor James Woods, Gloomius Maximus sets out to steal the fun from everyone.
No!
Looks like the last laugh is mine.
Until Oly gears up to save the day.
I guess we'll have to be great defenders of fun. Yeah!
And only on DVD, get a hilarious bonus cartoon, a DVD storybook, and a cool multi-level game just for kids.
Yay!
Blast off into a galaxy of giggles with Roly Poly Oly, the great defender of fun, premiering only on Disney DVD and video August 13th.
It's time to power up with two all-new adventures with the Power Rangers.
Awesome!
Coming to you on home video, Power Rangers Time Force takes you on the ride of your life with the all-new Dawn of Destiny and the Time Force season finale, The End of Time.
All right!
These two videos will kick up non-stop action to experience again and again. Plus, coming soon to own on home video, the all-new Power Rangers Wild Force. It's the ultimate in home entertainment.
Thank you.
here. I can't see nothing. I'm blind. I'm blind. I can't see.
Whoa, what's wrong? What happened?
Oh, I killed a baby bumblebee.
Oh, come on. Will you quit your bawling? Could be a lot worse.
Well, I don't see how it could be worse.
Gross.
Son, I drive my tires over a mile of busted glass just to see that picture right there. Dadgum!
Of all these strangers.
Oh dear, I'll be so late. And whiskers, look how late it's getting. Late.
Perhaps I fell right through the earth and come out the other side. I shall have to ask somebody the name of the country. Please, ma'am, is this New Zealand or Australia? Strange. Now that I'm in, how do I get out? From a bottle marked poison, it's almost certain to disagree with you sooner or later. This bottle's not marked poison. What am I supposed to do? curiouser and curiouser. If it makes me grow taller, then I can reach the key. And if it makes me grow smaller, I can creep under the door. Either way, I'll get into the garden.
Absolutely savage if I keep her waiting.
Please, sir, can you help me?
Are you crying?
Yes. Not that much of an ordeal, though.
Well, fortunately, I speak both crying and sobbing fluently. But I can't stay. I'm late.
No. Yesterday everything was so normal. Now look at me, I'm huge. And I'm stuck. I wonder what's making me grow smaller. Must be this fan.
Lady.
You did look like a mouse.
I'm late. Come with me. I have a very important lecture to deliver, and everyone will be there. My lectures have to be seen and heard to be depreciated. Of course, they divide people. Last time, the whole audience hissed, all except one man. He was applauding the hissing. What am I going to talk about? What am I going to do? Whatever it is I'll talk about, you can be sure it isn't new. Not new. Not new. I am an English lecturer, the most famous of my time, because I stick with the same old words and never change a line. Not a line. Not a line. No, not a line. My mother couldn't carry a tune, not even if it had handles. Silly old trout. Oh, a most depressing venue. The distemper's coming off of the knees. Still, the audience look lively enough. That's the main thing. I mean, they're not dead. Yet. What's your name, if it isn't a rude question?
Alice.
Oh, well, that's not your fault.
You're wet.
Sit down. I'll soon make her dry enough. My lecture is the driest thing I've ever heard of. Settle down, everybody, whilst I clear my throat.
Get on with it, walnuts.
William the Conqueror, whose cause was favored by the Pope.
Ow! Ow!
Did you speak?
I don't think so.
Edwin and Morcar, the earls of Mercia and Northumbria, declared for him. And even Stigand, the patriotic Archbishop of Canterbury, found it advisable to go with Edgar Atheling to meet William and offer him the crown. How are you getting on now, my dear?
I'm as wet as ever. Doesn't seem to dry me at all.
Are you sure? Oh, I don't like the sound of it.
None of us do. In which case, I move the meeting adjourn. Can we immediately, if not sooner, adopt more energetic remedies to facilitate a cure for witness, Percy?
Speak English!
What I was going to say was, ipso facto, the best thing to get her dry would be a caucus race.
What's a caucus race?
A caucus race! A caucus race!
What's a caucus race?
I'll pick a few things.
Now you're talking.
Yes, I am talking. Now what's a caucus race?
The best way to explain a caucus race is to do it! On your marks! Get set! Go!
It's a blistering race! An extraordinary display of skill, determination, sheer stupidity!
Steve, did everybody win? Oh. And we must all have prizes.
Ah. Who's going to give the prizes?
Why, Elise, of course.
Oh.
I think it's time we were all in bed with a cup of hot chocolate.
Indubitably.
Wait, where are you all going? Wait.
Oh, the Duchess! Oh, my sweet paws! Oh, my fur and whiskers! She'll get me executed as sure as ferrets are ferrets.
Oh, what have you lost, sir?
A pair of white kid gloves and a fan.
Oh, I'll help you find them.
What are you doing here?
I'm trying to get into the beautiful garden.
Run home and fetch me another pair of gloves and a fan. Quick! Oh!
He's treating me as if I'm his housemaid. Frederick Rabbit's house. Very well for a rabbit. Some of these things must be priceless, or even more expensive. It doesn't say drink me like the other bottle. I'm sure it will make something interesting happen. I just hope it makes me grow large again. Ugh, that's enough.
Window. Pat! Pat!
I'm here, Your Honor. I'm here. I was out the front digging for apples. Oh, but sure. It's a dewy dawn when the lark's on the wing and the snail's on the horn. What?
Oh, not now, Pat. Just help me out of this.
All right, come on. Oh. Come on. Oh, no, that won't do the vegetables any good, Your Honor.
Why are we growing cucumbers, Pat?
Because they're green, Your Worship.
I thought so. Now tell me, Pat, what's that in the window?
Let's have a look. Hang on a sec.
That's an arm, Your Worship. An arm? Whoever saw an arm that size?
No one, but sure, it's still an arm.
Well, it's no business there. Remove it.
Me, Your Worship?
Yes, you. Are you a coward?
Ah, no, not at all. I might have coward's legs, but the rest of me's as brave as a lion.
There's nothing to be afraid of.
Well, then you do it.
I'm too rich. I can't afford to die.
Ah! Will somebody please help me? I'm stuck. I'm stuck. Why won't anyone help me? I can't do it by myself.
Why do you keep falling like that, Your Honor?
I like it. Oh, help me up.
Oh, right so. Here, take me right hand. There we go. Oh, no. That's me right hand. Bill!
Hello.
You're needed, lad.
What's the matter, sir?
Master's got a terrible case of a fall. Oh.
Get a ladder.
Oh, right. Now be careful with that ladder, lad. You might hit. Oh.
No! Sorry, sir.
Oh. Put the ladder up against the house.
Oh.
Yes, yes. That's good. Now, climb up.
What for?
You've got to get on the roof, slide down the chimney, and see who's in the house.
Why?
Because I can't get through the door or windows.
No, sir, that's a mighty clever idea. But you see, I've got a bad back for chimneys. I inherited it from my mother. We've always had terrible backs for chimneys.
Oh, you do it, Bill.
Who, me?
Yes, you.
Oh, all right then.
Here you go.
Quick. Hurry.
Oh, Now, careful, Bill. There's a loose slate up there somewhere. Ah, good man.
You found it.
Pat, tell him to climb down the chimney.
Bill!
How?
Climb down the chimney!
Lad.
Hold up his head. Here's brandy.
Ah, thank you, Your Worship.
Not you.
Ah, sorry. Purely medicinal. Runs in the family.
What happened, Bill?
Well, something comes at me. Like a jack-in-the-box. And then up I goes. Like a skyrocket.
Spoken like a true Irishman, Bill.
I don't like the look of this. There's nothing for it. We must burn down the house.
Good thinking, Your Worship. You'd like me to sing some melodies of old Ireland?
No, just burn down the house.
Oh, no, you don't. You're not burning down this house while I'm inside.
Ah, a barrow full should do.
Great! Here we go! Around and around and away!
Stop it! You better not do that again! Go and find that lovely garden. No one will think of looking for me there. Everything seems different from down here. I have to keep looking up. I'm sure little people must get very bad neck strain. It's enough to make a cat bark. When I used to read fairy tales, I never thought I would end up in the middle of one. There ought to be a book written about me. Maybe when I grow up, I'll write one.
Thank you.
who do I have the honor of addressing?
Major Caterpillar, Ribbon and Bar, late of Her Majesty's Foot and Light, a true son of England and his flag, what? Who are you?
I don't really know.
If you don't, I don't.
I know who I was this morning, but I think I've been changed several times since then.
Explain yourself, or you'll find yourself on a charge.
Well, I can't explain myself, sir, because I'm not myself, you see.
No, I don't see.
Everyone should be the right size, shouldn't they? But I've been so many different sizes in one day, it's very confusing.
Why?
Well, if you were to change into a butterfly, say, you'd find it quite strange, wouldn't you?
Not a bit of it. Nothing strange to me.
I don't think you should talk to me like that.
Like what?
In short sentences.
Oh.
All I know is that it's very disturbing. Sometimes I start crying.
Why?
Because I don't remember things like I used to. And I can't keep the same size for 10 minutes together.
That's a rum do. I'd keep an eye on it if I were you. Can't remember what things exactly.
Songs and poems.
Scared? Worse than having the beriberi. Recite! You are old Father William. Stand up, girl. You can't sing or recite without standing up.
Well, that's just it. I don't want to.
No, elbows all wrong. Tuck them in. Tuck them in!
Good. Try and keep in tune.
You are old, Father William, the young man said, and your hair has become very white. And yet you incessantly stand on your head. Do you think at your age this is right?
I don't know if you were trying for the Paganini variations for voice and trumpet, but you missed 5 verses.
Some of the words did get a little altered.
Young lady, it was wrong from beginning to end, and you can't get wronger than that.
I'm afraid that's what always happens when I have to perform.
You mustn't be afraid. That's worse than not remembering.
Oh, dear.
What size do you want to be? Speak up! Speak up!
I don't care about the size, just so long as I'm not changing all the time, you know?
No, I don't know.
There you go again with your short sentences.
There you go, losing your temper. It's against Queen's regulations. Do you like your size right now?
I'd like to be a little taller. This is a terrible height to be.
Terrible? Gad, whoa!
One side will make you taller, the other side will make you shorter.
One side of what?
The mushroom. That's what it's there for. Everything has a purpose, even here.
Thank you, Major. One side makes me taller. The other side will make me shorter. I wonder which one is which.
For the Duchess, an invitation from the Queen to play croquet.
From the Queen, an invitation for the Duchess to play croquet.
An invitation to play croquet from the Queen for the Duchess.
I've got the gist.
You sure?
Yes, it's an invitation from the Queen for the Duchess to play croquet.
I wouldn't put it quite like that, but I have to do, I suppose.
No good you knocking like that.
Why not?
Two good reasons. One, because I'm on the same side of the door as you.
Oh, yes.
Two, they're making so much noise inside, no one can hear you.
But how am I going to get inside?
That is the question. The problem. You might even say the conundrum or riddle.
Yes, I might.
There'd be some sense in you knocking if we had a door between us. I could go and get a spare door, but that would take too long. On the other hand, if you were inside the house, you could knock and I could let you out. Knock, knock. This way out, madame.
But I don't want to go out. I want to go in.
Of course, but if you did want to go out, it would be much easier. Meanwhile, I'm going to sit here until tomorrow. Or the next day, perhaps. Or even for a whole week. Then I can come back by popular demand.
But how am I supposed to get inside? I need to ask them a question.
Will you ever get in is the question you should be asking. I'm going to sit here for days thinking about it and singing Coming Through the Rye.
It's no use talking to you. I'll just have to do it myself.
That's the spirit.
Please, could you tell me why your cat is grinning at me like that?
He's a Cheshire cat. Cheshire cats always grin. Isn't that so, Piggy?
I didn't know Cheshire cats always grinned. In fact, I didn't know cats could grin.
Well, you don't know very much then, do you? Isn't that so, Piggy?
Are you really a duchess?
Every inch.
Hit his poor little nose.
Nonsense! He can already play Three Blind Mice on his nose flute. What do you want, little miss?
I want to know how to get into the garden.
Now you're talking. But I prefer singing to talking, don't you? Let's have a song. Speak roughly to the little boy and beat him when he sneezes. He only does it to annoy because he knows it pleases. Severely to my boy, I beat him when he sneezes, for he can thoroughly enjoy the purple when he pleases.
prizes.
They're sure to kill you.
No! Ben!
I thought you wanted to go in.
I've been in, now I'm coming out.
Life is so complicated.
You mustn't grunt like that. You sound as if you've turned into a pig. You have turned into a pig. I'd best let you go. Go on. When he gets older, he'll make a very ugly child. Or a very handsome pig. Can you tell me which way to go?
Well, that depends on where you want to get to.
The garden.
Why do you want to go there?
It looks safe.
Sometimes things that look safe turn out nasty. And things that look nasty turn out safe. That's a moral.
What sort of people live around here?
Well, a hatter lives over there. Follow my pointing paw. And a gentleman called Hare, nicknamed March, lives there. They're probably having a tea party. They're both mad.
But I don't want to meet mad people.
But you can't help it. Everyone here is mad. I'm mad. You're mad. It's only by chance and careful planning if you're not.
How do you know I'm mad?
Because you're here. And everyone here is mad. I went to a hunt ball once. I didn't like it. Terrible people. They all started hunting me.
Life must be hard for you.
But I grin and bear it. By the by, what became of the baby?
It turned into a pig.
I knew it would. It's the same with crows and moorhens. Did you say pig or fig?
I said pig, and I wish you wouldn't keep appearing and disappearing so suddenly. You're making me very dizzy.
Oh, so sorry. Is this better?
Which way shall you go? Which path shall you take? If you don't take any, you will make a mistake. Which way shall you go? Which path shall you take? You have to move on, though you tremble and quake.
The Cheshire Cat was right. They are having tea. I wonder if they'd mind if I joined them.
Have you any more food down there, Dormy? Any spoilt sandwiches or strawberries? I love strawberries, don't you?
I'm sure he's hoarding them.
I'm lost. Could I get some...
No! There's no room!
There's plenty of room.
Why didn't you report this sooner, Hattie?
I overslept.
Why are you here?
Well, I've been looking for the pretty garden all day, and now I'm tired and hungry.
Oh, that's different.
We've been eating for hours.
And we're not finished yet!
Waiter, there's a hare in my soup.
Is it blonde? We're missing a waitress.
Have some wine.
I don't see any wine.
There isn't any, and you're too young.
Then it wasn't very nice of you to offer it.
It wasn't very nice of you to sit down without an invitation. This is a private soiree.
Well, I suppose I shouldn't have just barged in. I know I wasn't invited, but the table was laid out for a lot of people.
My response to that is both profound and meaningful. Get your hair cut.
You shouldn't make personal remarks. It's very rude.
I didn't know that. Personal remarks are rude.
Mm-hmm.
Egad, you learn something new every day. Make a note of that, March. It might come in useful. Now, I have one for you.
Ooh.
Why is the raven like a writing desk?
Why is a raven...
I'm not talking to you.
Why not? Aren't I good enough?
You've had it before.
But you were looking at me when you said, why is a raven...
I'm asking Alice!
Why is a raven like a writing desk? You know, I'm pretty sure I can guess.
You mean you think you know the answer?
Yes.
Then you should say what you mean.
Well, I do. At least I mean what I say. That is the same thing.
It's not the same thing at all. You might as well say, I see what I eat. It's the same thing as I eat what I see.
You might as well say, I like what I get, but I get what I like.
You might as well say, I breathe when I sleep. It's the same thing as I sleep when I breathe.
Well, it is the same with you. Clean cups! Time mortars on its stomach!
That's curious. I'll manage things better.
Mr. Five, you're splashing paint.
I couldn't help it, Mr. Two. Mr. Seven dropped my elbow.
Oh, that's right. Shifting the responsibility again.
You can talk. I heard the Queen say you deserve to be beheaded.
What for?
Tulip roots.
What?
For bringing the cook tulip roots instead of onions.
Is that all? That's a mistake anyone can make.
Hello.
Hello. Hello.
Why are you painting the roses red?
Well, the fact is, miss, this tree ought by rights to have been a red rose tree, and we planted a white one by mistake.
Easy thing to do.
Yes.
If the Queen was to find out, well, the fact is, we'd all have our heads cut off.
So you see, miss, we're doing our best to put things right.
Before she comes.
Right, left.
And who is this?
I agree in time.
Ridiculous.
Would I lie to you, Majesty? Oh, thank you. Compliments are always welcome.
You're an idiot.
That's right, Your Majesty. Only you could spot that. It's one to know one.
Complete idiot. Your name, child? Alice, if it please Your Majesty.
I'll be stopped.
I'm a stranger here. Stop losing your temper. It's welcome.
Consider, my dears, he's just a child.
Yes, you'll account for it.
You three! Get
out! Stop doing that, you're making me dizzy.
What is this?
If it please Your Majesty, we're trying.
Yes. You are, aren't you?
Very trying.
I won't let you be beheaded. Quick, right. Jumping in. Fond of beheading people. Ah, it's the Cheshire Cat. Hello there.
How do you like the game?
They don't play very fair.
But nobody does if they think they can get away with it. That's a lesson you'll have to learn.
Well, I should have croqueted the Queen's hedgehog, but my hedgehog wouldn't roll into a ball.
Well, you've got to look at it from the hedgehog's point of view.
Yes, I suppose I should have.
How do you like the Queen?
I don't. She's so extremely... likely to win that it's hardly worth finishing the game.
Who are you talking to?
A friend of mine. Cheshire Cat, this is the king.
Oh, I don't like this at all. But as you're in the presence, you may kiss my hand.
I'd rather not.
What? That's rank insubordination. And you know what that leads to. And don't look at me like that.
A cat may look at a king.
What does that mean?
I read it in a book somewhere.
I haven't, but it sounds immoral. It has undertones. That book should be banned.
I like the sound of that.
Ah, my dear, how do we get rid of a floating cat?
Off with its head.
Brilliant. I knew I could rely on you, my dear.
I'll just go and fetch the executioner.
Do you know where my hedgehog went?
He rolled away over there.
Now stop it. It's all right. I'm not going to hurt you.
What's necessary is a foot to the back of the neck.
called
for. I must have a ruling. I appeal to you, little girl.
You've still got a good head on your shoulders.
No thanks to you.
What?
I can't hear what you say. One at a time, please.
I'm sorry about my altitude.
That's a revolution! You're above us!
My argument is simple. Based on irrefutable logic. I'm chief executioner. But I can't cut off an head unless there's a body to cut it from. You see a cat hanging up there, large as life and twice as repulsive as no body. Ipso facto, I cannot separate it from its head.
My argument is, I venture to say, overwhelming. Anything that has a head can be beheaded. And don't forget, I'm also a justice of the peace.
There's too much talk and not enough action. And if something doesn't happen in a minute, I'm going to have everybody executed.
You choose, little girl.
To behead or not to behead, that is the question.
What's the... Girl,
you have to tread with care when dealing with cats. They have influence and are seen in all the smart places. You remember the Great Cat Massacre?
Oh, yes. I was forgetting. Catastrophe.
I'd think carefully before acting rashly.
Sound advice, little girl.
And another thing. The cat belongs to the Duchess.
She's in prison! Fetch her!
I remember the Great Cat Massacre of 28. Nasty business.
Yes, it was just after the Great Flamingo Plague of 26.
Duchess, think carefully before answering this question. Is this your cat?
No. No.
It isn't? I was told. Ah, it's gone. It's your fault. It was in your custody.
It wasn't official, so it's nothing to do with me, mate. I'm in the clear.
Help me find it. Everybody, help.
Glad I am to see you again, you old thing.
Thank you.
You look worried, my dear.
I don't want to go back and sing that song.
The show must go on.
Why?
Life would be very dull if it didn't.
Open your head!
The game's going better now.
And the moral of that is, the more there is of mine, the less there is of yours.
Or you could say, fortune favours the brave.
I could, but I will. Fortune favours the brave. Oh, that's a good moral. You are a clever old thing, you. Fine day, Your Majesty.
I gave you fair warning. Either you or your head must be...
Such a lovely garden after all. Now where have I got to? Oh dear.
I was forgetting. Perhaps this is the way out. Tiger Lily, I wish you could talk so you could tell me how to get out of this wood.
I can talk. When there's anybody worth talking to.
Can all flowers talk?
As well as you.
Oh, it isn't manners for us to speak first. We were wondering if you'd speak.
I thought your face had got some sense on it. Not much, but some.
But the colouring's right.
Oh, I don't care about her colour. If only her petals curled more, she'd be all right.
Aren't you frightened of growing out here, with no one to look after you?
There are plenty of trees. What else are they good for?
What good are trees when danger comes near?
They have a good bark.
You didn't know that, did you?
Silence, all of you. They're only like that because I can't get at them. They're too close to the ground.
If you're not polite, I'll make you into a chain.
Daisies are worst of all, next to snapdragons.
How is it that all of you can talk so well? I've been in lots of gardens and I've never heard flowers talk before.
Feel the ground.
It's very hard.
Ah. In most gardens, the flower beds are too soft, so the flowers are always asleep.
I see. I never thought of that.
In my opinion, I doubt if you ever think at all.
Hold your tongue, all of you.
Now, which way out of the wood?
That way.
That way.
Yeah, this way. That way.
Definitely that way.
That way.
Standing still as waxworks.
And if you think we're waxworks, you should pay for the privilege of looking. Hmm? Waxworks aren't made to be looked at for nothing.
No, how? Contrarywise, if you think we're alive, we ought to introduce ourselves.
I am Mr. Tweedledum, and this is Mr. Tweedledee.
I'm Alice.
Is the name Veronica Buff mean anything to you?
No, who is she?
I don't know, but we're obviously doing her a favor, mentioning her.
Do you think she'll be grateful if she becomes famous?
No!
How?
I was just thinking of that poem of you two. Tweedledum and Tweedledee agreed to have a battle, for Tweedledum said Tweedledee had spoiled his nice new rattle. Just then flew down a monstrous crow as black as a tar barrel, which frightened both the heroes so they quite forgot their quarrel.
There's no monstrous crow.
You recited that poem very nicely. Congrats. But it isn't us.
No.
It's another set of Tweedledums and Tweedledees altogether. Completely different people. But the names are the same.
Contrarywise, you began all wrong.
Yes. Yes, after you said, I'm Alice, you should have said, how doody, and shake hands.
Ta-da!
Now, shake.
Here we go round the mulberry bush, the mulberry bush, the mulberry bush. Here we go round the mulberry bush on a cold and frosty morning.
Twice round's enough for any dance.
I hope you're not too tired.
No way, no way. Thank you for asking. As we began with poetry and song, let's continue that way.
I'm sorry. I haven't time.
Neither have we. We never carry a watch.
No how.
The poem's called The Walrus and the Carpenter. You'll love it. Ta-da! You start, brother mine. The sun was shining on the sea. The sun was shining on the sea, shining with all his might. He did his very best to make the billows smooth and bright. And this was odd because it was the middle of the night.
The walrus and the carpenter were walking close at hand. They weren't like anything to see such quantities of sand.
If this were only cleared away,
it really would be grand.
If seven maids with seven mops swept for half a year, do you suppose that they could get it clear?
I doubt it very much.
And he shed a bitter tear.
Sorry.
Hello.
Oh, oysters. Will you walk with us?
The walrus de beseech.
A pleasant walk, a pleasant talk along the briny beach. But we cannot do with more than four to give a hand to each. The eldest oyster looked at him, but never a word he said. Meaning to say he did not choose to leave the oyster bed.
But four young oysters hurried out, all eager for the treat. Their coats were brushed, their faces washed, their shoes were clean and neat, and this was odd.
And why was that?
Because they hadn't any feet.
The time has come,
the walrus said,
to talk of many things, of shoes and ships and sealing wax, of cabbages and kings, and why the sea is boiling hot. And whether pigs have wings.
Wait a bit,
the oysters cried.
Before we have our chat, for some of us are out of breath, and all of us are fat.
There really is no hurry.
We thank you very much for that.
A slice of bread is what we chiefly need. Pepper and vinegar besides are very good indeed. So if you're ready, oysters dear, we can begin to feed.
But not on us! Not on us! See, we're turning a little blue. After such kindness, that would be a dismal thing to do.
Yes, it was very kind of you to come. And you're very nice.
Give us another slice, my friend. Huh? Give us another slice. I wish you were not quite so deaf. I've had to ask you twice.
Well, it seems a shame, I must confess, to play them such a trick when we brought them so far and made them trot so quick.
Look at this. Look at this. The butter's spread too thick.
I weep for you. I really do. I deeply sympathize. With sobs and tears, he sorted out those of the largest size, holding his pocket handkerchief before his streaming eyes.
Oh, oysters, I have to say, you've had a pleasant run. Shall we be trotting home again?
But answer came there none.
And this was scarcely odd because
they'd eaten every one.
Oh, woeful weeping walrus, your tears are all a sham. You're greedier for oysters than children are for jam.
So, what's the verdict?
I like the walrus best, because he did feel a little sorry for the oysters.
Chaw! He ate more than Carpenter!
In that case, I like the Carpenter better, if he didn't eat as many as the walrus.
Ate as many as he could get.
Then they're both very nasty characters.
Duh! Oh.
Worse.
What is it?
It was the Red King snoring.
Yes, it's the King of Hearts' lazy, no good brother. Every family has one.
Except ours.
We've got two. Come, let's have a look at him.
He's dreaming about you. You're only a sort of thing in his dream.
Yes, he woke up now. You go up. Puff.
I would not. Besides, if I'm only a sort of thing in his dream, then what are you two? I'm going.
Well, all's well that ends well.
It's the car!
Alice, you are hereby and forthwith summoned to attend the trial of Sir Jack, the Knave of Hearts.
How do I look?
Too early to say.
Again on soprano sax.
What are they doing? They can't have anything to write. The trial hasn't begun yet.
They're putting down their own names in case they forget them by the time the trial is over.
Stupid things.
Stupid. How do you spell stupid?
S-T... What's after tea?
Dinner. Is it dinner time? It's dinner time.
No, it's dinner time.
No, it isn't.
I swore it was dinner time. My stomach feels like my throat. I never seen
are too easy. Chop off more bits. It's wonderful. Chop, chop. Blood everywhere. Proud.
You missed.
Oh, it did? Never mind, I felt it anyway.
I'm not going to be called, am I?
Called what?
I don't want to stand up in front of all these people. Why am I here?
To save Jack from a death worse than fate.
Clerk of the court, read the accusation.
The Queen of Hearts, she made some tarts all on a summer day. The
name of heart, he stole those tarts and took them right away.
Oh, I confess, I didn't do it. And I'm glad, glad, glad I didn't do it. And if I had my time again, I'd probably still wouldn't do it.
Meg, open and shut the case.
That can't be right.
Say something, Alice.
No.
That's over. Members of the jury, 12 good picks and true. You must retire and consider your verdict.
Not yet.
Why not?
There's a great deal more to come before you can say that.
It's odd, not to say strange.
Gentlemen of the jury, it is obvious the accused is guilty. Put aside the evidence and look at his face. It is the face of a habitual criminal. A hardened felon, a recalcitrant rogue. What is it?
We're lawyers for the defense.
Oh, rest my case.
Call the first witness.
Call the first witness.
Call the first witness.
Call the first witness.
Call the first witness. Call the first witness.
Call the first witness. Call the first witness.
Good day.
Good day.
I'm sorry for bringing these things in with me. I hadn't quite finished my tea when I was home.
She never finishes his tea.
It is terrible. All those cucumber sandwiches. Look at his legs.
I can't.
That's what I mean. He's got a case of cucumber legs. The worst I've ever seen. And I've seen a few in my time.
Well, you're a fine one to talk, Tubby.
You ought to have finished tea.
What time did you start?
I'll have to ask Mr. Hell.
Send for me. I didn't finish the sentence.
I haven't passed one yet, Your Majesty.
Oh, that's right. What? 14. 14.
Yeah, 15.
16. Write that down.
14, 15, and 16.
14, 15, and 16. Now, subtract, multiply, and convert to rands and kilos. What's the answer? Yeah. I should be able to do it in their heads.
Bad hat! Disrespect to this court, take it off.
And his head with it.
I can't. Your Honor, why can't you take it off, pray? It isn't mine.
Stolen! Members of the jury, write that down.
Stolen hat one. This man is a self-confessed thief. He has the gall to come into this court as a character witness.
He seems very prejudiced.
Oh, thank you, Alice. That's what makes me so eminently qualified to be a judge.
Oh, yeah. No time yet.
I shall have.
Not in my end. I'm a hatter. Why didn't you say so? That's the first thing you should have said.
Give us your evidence.
Don't be nervous. Oh, no. We'll execute you on the spot.
I'm not nervous. I've nothing to hide. Done my duty. Serve my country.
I do know.
Oh!
Summer 41, or was it Heidelberg? Hatter, your evidence.
It's just making you more nervous. Stay calm, Mr. Hatter.
I'm a poor man, Your Honor. And I haven't had my tea. And what with the sandwich is getting ruined after being eaten one? And the twinkling of the teacup.
Twinkling?
You're the twinkler!
What did he say?
Treacle.
Yes, Mr. Dormouse. He's no right to be here. Look at his whiskers.
Call the next witness. Call Alice.
Oh.
happens.
I don't like being called up here like this.
I should like it if it happened to me.
People like being the center of attention. Now, what do you know about this business with the tarts?
Whatsoever.
Oh, that's very important. Unimportant,
Your Majesty.
Unimportant, of course, is what I mean to say. Unimportant. Unimportant.
Unimportant. I've told you all I know. I'd like to go back to my seat now.
We're moved by your plea, but I'm reminded of Rule 42. All persons more than a mile high have to leave Wonderland.
I'm not a mile high.
More like 2 miles high.
You just invented that
rule. It's the oldest rule in the book.
Then it should be rule number one.
Careful, Cedric. They're taking over the court. Especially that girl. Punish somebody.
You've too much to say for yourself, Alice. Jury, consider your verdict.
Sentence passed.
Verdict?
That's stupid.
Come here, Alice.
I can't let you condemn an innocent man.
Why not? It happens all the time.
Don't keep shouting off with a head in case someone shouts off with yours.
Lost your last chance of staying here. It's back to the real world for you, young lady.
I don't care. All the tarts are here, so how could the prisoner have stolen them? There is no crime.
Alice, don't you care what people think?
Not when I'm right.
Are you so confident, young lady?
Yes, I am. Yes, I am confident.
Then you don't need us anymore.
Daughter Alice is going to sing for us.
It's cherry ripe, isn't it, dear?
No. I've got a better one. Will you walk a little faster, said a whiting to a snail.
Are you sure, dear?
Yes, I'm sure.
Will you walk a little faster, said a whiting to a snail. There's a porpoise close behind us and he's treading on my tail. See how eagerly the lobster and the turtles all advance. They are waiting on the shingle. Will you come and join the dance? Will you, won't you, will you, won't you join the dance? Will you, won't you, will you, won't you join the dance? Will you, won't you, will you, won't you join the dance?
Enchantress, an entire galaxy just begging to supply its resources to my machine empire.
You forget, Lord Zedd and Rita Repulsa claim this galaxy as their own.
A minor detail. Come, see for yourself.
Oh, boy.
As we speak, those piteous peasants are fleeing for their very existence.
We gotta buy the gears, huh, Dad?
Precisely.